Hello, my name is Azad Mardan, and in this short video, I wanted to share with you 5 reasons why JavaScript is so amazing, 5 reasons why you should learn it now. Reason number 1, you don't have to depend on anyone. Yes, working in teams could be sometimes good, but most of the times you spend way too much time on communication, on Slack messages, on reading the documentation provided by the other team members, or just plain good old boring meetings. Who wants that? So with full-stack JavaScript, you can be basically a one-person team. You can do everything, and that will speed up things dramatically. And also, you don't have to depend on anyone, especially if you're a startup person, you're building your own startup, or you're building a prototype, or you're building a project. Being able to do everything yourself, this is great. 10 years ago, you couldn't imagine that that would be possible. And now with just one technology, with JavaScript, you can do everything. So obviously the browser, the front end, the UI, that's powered by the JavaScript, right? So no question about that. What about the backend? What about your RESTful API? So maybe you have a GraphQL backend, or you have a database. That's also JavaScript with node.js and databases such as MongoDB, which by the way supports JavaScript interface. Again, you don't have to learn a separate language. You don't have to depend on another person. It's JavaScript. That's not all. What about deployment? I remember before you would zip your file, or you would send your SVN package, or now it's GitHub. So you would send those to a separate IT ops team, and then they would do the deployment. So not anymore. With Amazon Web Services, Microsoft Azure, Google Cloud, all those major cloud providers, they all support JavaScript. So you can write a small JavaScript script to automate the deployment using SDKs, or you can just use functions as a service, which is basically JavaScript functions. You just copy and paste them, put them in a cloud, and they're working. They are serving your traffic, and they're getting the information from the database. They're saving to the database. But that's not all either. You can use JavaScript to build mobile applications, and not some slow, old, boring HTML5 type of application. You might heard about PhoneGap or Cordova. You can build native applications with JavaScript. React Native is a great example of that. And the last thing, JavaScript is used a lot in the Internet of Things. So for example, you want to build a smart home. You have a bulb that you want to control from a mobile application, or you have a smart TV. So all that is most likely supported by JavaScript. Reason number 2, why you should learn full stack JavaScript now. You can be moved, or you can join a cooler company, or you can be moved to a more interesting project, because most of the new interesting, exciting projects, and also companies such as startup companies and also big companies, Fortune 500 companies in Silicon Valley and San Francisco, they tend to use those JavaScript technologies, those modern technologies. So if you want to have a little change in scenery, join a cooler team or a cooler company with a lot of those perks, such as a tennis table, free juices, free massages, full stack JavaScript is the way to go. Reason number 3, why you should learn full stack JavaScript. You can be more productive. There are a lot of people developing in JavaScript. There are a lot of developers, and some of them, they're really, really, really smart. So what is happening, there are a lot of innovation happening in the JavaScript world. So you want to tap into that open ecosystem of modules, libraries, frameworks, also big companies such as Netflix, Facebook, they invest a lot of resources. They support those developers. React came out of Facebook and Instagram. So you want to get on that train, because you can ship more code, better quality code in less time. And sometimes you don't even have to code. I'm sure there's probably a module or a library, you just get it from npm and boom, it's working. All you need to do is maybe put some Twitter Bootstrap or Material UI on top of that, and it's good to go. Other times you have to tweak it a little bit. You just fork a library, and you can use it with very minimal coding. Reason number four, you can get a pay raise. That's kind of obvious. The more you learn, the more of the recent technologies and the more productive you are. And if you can do everything by yourself, that's a no-brainer. You will get a pay raise. Or you can join another company and ask for a pay raise. That's a no-brainer. And the last reason, probably the coolest one, it's actually fun. It's actually super fun because JavaScript, it's a fun language. It's very expressive. You don't spend a lot of time spinning the wheels. There's also additional languages that build upon JavaScript, such as TypeScript, that would give you some typing and some more tooling. So it's just pure fun. I remember in previous years, when I was working on Java, I was spending way too much time setting up classes, interfaces, inheriting them. With JavaScript, I just go straight up and create a function, and that function solves the problem. So no big fuss. So those are five reasons. You can basically do anything yourself. You don't have to depend on anyone. You can join a cool project or a cool company. You can be more productive, you can get a pay raise, and your job will be more fun. Why I'm creating those September webinars? People can read a book, they can read a free online blog post on full stack JavaScript, Node.js, React Native. That's great, that's fine. But most people get distracted, and there is way too much information out there. You don't know what's recent, what is not so recent. There are a lot of versions, a lot of changes. There are a lot of modules to pick from. So having those webinars that I'm putting together in September will give you just the necessary information without any BS. So you would be saving a lot of time. And also there is very little chance you will be going on and checking cat videos on YouTube or going on Facebook and messaging with your friends, because you would be pretty much all day in a webinar, asking questions, working on the labs, very little distraction. You get just a more immersive learning experience. And then there is no travel. In-person live trainings, they're great, but you would have to spend a few hundred dollars to fly and be with me. The last training we did was in LA. We had about 20 people, but most people cannot get a US visa, and then it takes a few days to travel and it costs you a few thousand dollars more. So the remote format is more convenient. You can just do it in your PJs, in your home, drinking your favorite cup of coffee. And then the live training, the benefit of the live training is that you get to ask live questions and they would be pretty much answered close to the real time. It's not like you're watching a recorded video. There are a lot of videos on Udemy, Udacity, and then maybe you can ask a question in a comment and maybe someone will answer you in a week. No, in my webinars, I get to the questions pretty much not right away. If I'm talking about a lecture, it's not going to be right away, but in a few minutes, 10 to 15 minutes, maybe half an hour. So you don't lose the context. You are right in the context. So I'm putting the webinars, but you might wondering who am I, why I'm doing the webinars, why I'm talking about the full stack JavaScript. Well, the reason number one, I'm very passionate about full stack JavaScript because it made me productive, and I see joy and happiness on the faces of developers who switch to the good side, to the side of the full stack JavaScript from other technologies. I'm not going to name the names. So that's kind of my mission. And the second reason is that I have some expertise I want to share. And this is a very convenient format. As I mentioned, there is no travel involved, and I get to teach more people at once. My sort of creds come from the fact that I wrote probably the most comprehensive book on the whole Node.js stack. It's called Practical Node.js. The name tells you a lot. So it's not just the book that focuses on one narrow library or one narrow approach or just a hello world. It's a book that encompasses all the Node.js stack. So starting with the template engines and server-side rendering, then RESTful APIs, then real-time and WebSockets, then deployment and the testing. So that book covers everything. This is how it looks like. It got over 100 reviews. Anyway, so that's my expertise. I also wrote many, many, many more books. Total count is 14 books. I taught probably 1,000 engineers in person, face to face, over the course of the last 5 years, mostly on Node.js, React, and other JavaScript, full stack JavaScript technologies. Lately, I've been doing more AWS trainings as well. And then through my courses, through my online courses on Udemy, Node University, and through my webinars and through my books, I've taught probably over 20 or 30,000 of software engineers. And I'm giving you rough estimates because pretty much all of my books that you see here, you can just get them for free online, which I don't mind, but my publisher definitely doesn't like it. I'm sure you can find me find more information on this Eventbrite page. And also you can check out some of my free blog posts on webapplog.com and Node University. The seminars are coming in September. It's a great way to immerse yourself, get something new once you off of the summer mode vacation, and maybe upgrade your career, maybe reignite your passion. Don't delay signing up for the webinars. The seats will be somewhat limited, and I recommend you getting the all four webinars with recording. That's the best value, because stuff happens. You might miss a webinar, or you might miss something like a word or a few sentences. So it's nice to have the recording so you can play it back over and over, or maybe just fast forward some of the parts when you're playing it back. So get the all four webinars package with recording, and I'll see you in September. Have a great day.